Hi there, my name's Jan Radu. Thanks for joining me today on my channel, stampingelegance.com. I am going to be making a small gift box and belly band that I shared recently on my Instagram. And the starting point for this project were these cute little Oreo packs that I got for my two boys for their lunch boxes. And they have two Oreos in them, and I really wanted to try and make a sweet little box that something like this can be given as a gift for Christmas. So as you can see, I am cutting the base of the box, and I've got the measurements on screen there for you. The base is 20 centimeters long by 8 centimeters wide, and the score line is going to be 1.5 centimeters. So you score from 1.5 centimeters in from each side. And our Stampin' Up trimmer is perfect for this project because you've got the cutting blade and then you've got this lighter blade, which is the scoring blade, all on the same tool. So I'm just checking to see that my Oreo packet fits within my score lines. And now I'm just using a bone folder, and I'm going to bend all of those edges in and give them a nice hard crease with my bone folder. So to create this box, it's really simple. You're just doing little snips on the score lines, as you can see I'm doing there. And I go in and do another little wedge out, and that just makes it easier to go together. And I'm using Stampin' Seal Plus, and I'm going to put a little bit of this strong adhesive on each of these little squares. And the box is as simple as tucking the little squares in and matching up the sides. So I'll go ahead and secure all of those, just shaping my box as I go. And now that I've got the base of the box done, I'll just check to see that the Oreos fit in, and I was really going for a nice snug fit here. So now we're going to cut the box lid, and those measurements are just going to be 0.3 centimeters longer and wider, so 20.3 and 8.3, and the score lines are going to be the same. So that just means that it's that little bit wider and longer so that it sits over the top of the box. As you can see, I've just gone through and followed the same method to create that lid, and it just fits nicely over the top. I'm using the Penguin Playmates DSP from the Celebration promotion today. And that promotion is on now, and you can earn this pack of 12 by 12 DSP for free with a qualifying order. So that's a $90 order in Australia. The mat measurements are 17 centimeters long and 5 centimeters wide. I've chose this sweet little spotty pattern for the top of my box. And now I'm just cutting the belly band. I'm cutting a 15 centimeter strip that's 5 centimeters wide. And I've used the coordinating kind of snowflake design on there. So you'll see I just measured to see just how long I needed the belly band to be, and 15 centimeters is just about right. So I'll go ahead and use my Tombow just to pop the DSP mat down on the top of my box. I'm keeping the box together while I do this assembly. It's just a little bit sturdier that way. Using the Tombow gives you that little bit extra wiggle room when you're putting your mat down. So once you put it down, you can actually move it around a little bit to make sure you've got a nice even margin around the end. Now I'm just popping my belly band across and using my fingers to create some nice sharp folds. And that just makes it a nice snug fit. And then it's going to wrap around at the back. You can use your bone folder like I am here just to create a bit of a flatter look. And you can just add some Stampin' Seal Plus is what I'm using. You really do want a strong adhesive. Tear and tape would work too. And then you just pop one flat down, and the flap with the adhesive goes over the top. Give it a little rub. Make sure that's a nice good stick. And you'll see that's now just going to slide up and down the box. So the recipient can just slide that belly band off and get to the treats inside. Now I'm using the Tasteful Labels dies. I love this set of dies. They do stack together nicely. They are coordinating shapes rather than the same shape in different sizes, and I do like that for a change. This label's one of my favourites, so I've chosen another stripe design in that same Penguin Playmates DSP, and I'm just going to go ahead and emboss around the edge of the die just to create a bit more dimension to my die piece. This just creates a nice embossed edge around your shape. I'm just using the stylus from my Stampin' Score, but there is a stylus on the Take Your Pick tool as well that you can use. So that fits nicely over there. And I'm just going to use dimensionals to attach that. So once your label's all lined up, you can have a test again. So it's much easier to slide when you've got the label to grab. These wonderful snowflakes, oh, these are so sweet. These are iridescent and they're in the current mini catalog. So you get quite a few sheets and they're separated by tissue paper. They're quite delicate, but when you pop them out, they actually come out quite easily. So I think this is going to be a real favorite embellishment to use for Christmas cards this year. And the middle of the snowflake is perfectly shaped to fit one of our dimensionals. So that makes it really easy to hide the adhesive that you're using. I'm just going to pop that one on there. And you've got some instant wow factor with those snowflakes. I'm using the Penguin Place Bundle today, which is also available in the mini catalogue, and it's a stamp set and a matching punch, which makes it quick and easy. And I'm using the Be Cool, Be Chill, Be Merry sentiment, but there's some general sentiments in there as well, so it's a really useful stamp set to have. This little jar is full of white, basic white strips of cardstock, and they're left over from when I'm chopping up mats, like four mats out of an A4 piece of paper. And these are what I call the endy bits, but they're absolutely perfect for strips of sentiments, like long sentiments like this one. So I always keep that jar handy, and then I can just reach for one of those strips and cut it to size. It's a real time saver for me. So I'm using the Misty Moonlight Stampin' Ink here, and once I've stamped that, I'm just going to cut my sentiment to size, clean my stamp off with my Stampin' Chamois, and now I'm just going to use the end bits of the Stampin' Dimensionals, so those long bits that you're left with when you've pulled all of your dimensionals off your sheet, they're perfect for sentiments like this. So here is the Penguin Builder Punch that comes in that Penguin Place bundle, and this is a really fun punch to use. Now here's a sheet of the DSP, and the punch actually punches perfectly that sweet little penguin. So I'm just going to chop that penguin out in a way that doesn't actually waste any of the other images. Trying to make the most of that very cute DSP sheet. So once I've opened my punch up, I can just slip that in and line up my penguin. And he punches out perfectly. Bringing in my Stampin' Pierce mat, and this is always useful for when you're stamping with photopolymer. You'll get a much nicer impression with some foam underneath. So I'm showing you three different options for creating your penguin for a little project like this. So the first one was obviously just punched straight out of the DSP, but this one here I'm going to be stamping. So I have got my penguin body loaded on one block, and I've got the beak and the feet as well. So I'm going to be stamping my penguin in Memento Black ink. Now you want to make sure you get a nice ink coverage on your penguin. So when you stamp it, just have a little look and make sure you've got enough coverage on there. It does stamp very nicely with the piercing mat underneath. I've got Calypso Coral that I'm going to use for his little feet. And we'll just pop those in there. So on the punch, there is actually a little flipper that you can punch out, coordinating cardstock or DSP, as I'm going to show you in just a moment. So there's our stamped penguin. Let's punch him out with the punch. Just going to trim my paper down to allow it to feed in a little easier into my punch there. And the other piece that punches out, you'll see in just a moment what that one's for. So there's option number two with the penguin. So you've got the stamped version there. Very, very cute. So the black 12 by 12 glitter paper, this is available in the mini catalogue. It's actually part of the Halloween suite towards the back. So I'm going to stamp out a glittery penguin and then use the other shape, which is actually the front of the penguin, out of basic white cardstock. And I'm actually using one of the little fox images, which is a really nice color for his flippers. So I'll just punch those out. That fox was only a partial print anyway, so I wouldn't have been able to fussy cut him and use him. So the stamp set comes obviously with a set of eyes for your penguin. So we load that one up on a block and I will be using the Memento black ink for that one too. And when you're stamping the eyes, they really do go up quite high. When I first started playing around with this, I realized I was going too low with the eyes and it looked really strange. So make sure you get that nice placement up quite high like I have here. And then with the beak, it also goes up quite high. Just underneath where the dip is between the two eyes. So when you're using glitter paper, you always need a nice strong glue like Tombow and just pop it down with a block to make it nice and flat, using my Take a Pick tool here just to add the little flippers on. And you can see that's the third option for the penguin. So you've got fully stamped, partially stamped, and then totally punched out of DSP. Three really cute looks, really versatile. It just gives you different options for when you're making your projects to make them all look a little bit different. Aren't they cute? So I'm just going to stamp a scarf in my favorite color, Fresh Freesia from the new In Colors. So stamping in Fresh Freesia onto basic white. Just hold your stamp down onto your paper for a couple of seconds. It just allows the ink to transfer and you'll get a much nicer stamp that way. I'm using a dark blue Stampin' Write marker. I didn't have Misty Moonlight, so I think I'm using maybe Midnight Muse. It's close enough. And I'm just creating different patterns on the scarf just for a little bit of interest. And I'll go ahead and fussy cut those out so we can dress up our penguin with the scarf. I've actually decided to go with the punched out DSP penguin for this project. And I'm adding my sentiment down with dimensionals. I'll go ahead and place my penguin down. I actually cut a little tree out of the DSP. You can see I've got a little bag full of all little cutout pieces and pre-made penguins there. So I've just added that little one and finishing off with some In Color jewels. I love this product. This is The iridescent self-adhesive jewels, they're in the matching in colours for this year. So I believe I'm using the Fresh Freesia, and I'm just going to pop a few of those down to finish off my project. I always like to go in odd numbers. Most people say the same thing. It's just visually more pleasing to the eye. And I also like to mix up if there's different sizes. I like to have, you know, a couple of small and a large, or just a variation there. And I'll end up putting the last little one on, I keep calling it a he, but it's really a she, on the little scarf. So as you can see, you can just slide that belly band off and open this sweet and simple box to see the treat inside. So you can use these this method for any different measurements. Just measure your product that you're boxing up and change the measurements accordingly. And you can make all sorts of different shapes and sizes using this same kind of idea. I hope you liked my project today. I would love you to subscribe for more videos, and thanks again for watching.